And joining us via phone from San Francisco is retired Lieutenant Eric Quema from the San Francisco Police Department. Thank you for joining us on BE.
Yes, Jill.
Lieutenant Quema, last month's massacre in Las Vegas and Tuesday's deadly truck attack in New York City shows that terrorists and bad guys are striking in the most random places. Now, given that this can happen anytime and anywhere, can people actually watch out for signs? How can they protect themselves?
Well, Jill, in these times of random and unpredictable violent attacks by one or more perpetrators, everyone's mindset should be, number one, awareness and attention to their surroundings, especially in public places or large gatherings. People should be in a condition called condition yellow, state of heightened awareness, and in a scanning mode, looking what's up ahead, to the right, left, what's behind. The signs are there if one's looking for it, but the perpetrators that look out of place, whether by clothing, movements, or items being carried, these are the times where we have to really ramp up our instincts and look out for each other and look for these signs.
Lieutenant Colonel Quema, in situations like these, instead of running away, some people choose to even linger and watch and even capture the horror that's unfolding on video. Are they risking their lives just to be citizen journalists?
Survival and safety dictate you put distance between you and whatever threat presents itself. Being a citizen journalist is putting oneself at great risk. You know, if unable to outrun a threat, you have to recognize there's immovable solid objects that you can hide behind as protective cover, considerations for children or elderly or physically challenged people with you. But the bottom line is you have to get out of harm's way. Being a citizen journalist is high risk. Mm-hmm. You're risking your life and those people that are with you, friends or family.
New York officials are promising increased security at the New York Marathon this Sunday, now following Tuesday's deadly terror attack. The question here is, should people just stay home and avoid big, crowded events for now?
Well, the answer to that, Joe, is a resounding no. We cannot allow terrorists and or criminals to dictate or alter our freedom to live our lives. Security and safety is everyone's responsibility, both first responders and the civilian population. From see something to say something, from detection to prevention to mitigation, we must present a proactive and unified front. But the bottom line is we cannot allow these terrorists to change and alter the course of our normalcy in our lives.
All right. Thank you for joining us via phone from San Francisco, retired lieutenant of the San Francisco Police Department, Eric Quema. Thank you.
Thank you, Phil.